Mm-hmm. There's dirt.
Dirt.
Let's see.
Mama, sorry. Yeah.
That's the root ball there. So let's dig in a little bit. This here is mint, and it died over the winter, but it's starting to come back in these little sprigs.
I'm just sitting.
So my thought was to potentially transplant some of this to another pot, and then use this one for either probably the peppers and this one for the tomatoes. Do you want to come down? Okay. Elodie here is going to help me. And we are going to get started. Okay, so I want to show you my peas that I have so far. I just picked these up from a local farmer. She was so sweet. I can't remember her name because it was something different. But I'm going to look up the Facebook listing and link it down below in case you want to get some plants in the Roughsdale, PA area. But she was so nice and she had a greenhouse and which is a sweet pepper that's green, but you can let it ripen to a red pepper, which is sweeter. And then this one is a German tomato that's similar to a beefsteak tomato with few seeds, so I figured that would be good. There is a teensy tiny little spider on this plant, so I'm going to give him a new home in the gravel.
Ooh,
okay. I think I got it. Okay. But let's get into transplanting these. So first what I'm going to do with this tomato plant is take these bottom leaves off, which is what she told me to do, and then plant it up to here so that the root system is all of this, which will give it a better foundation. So that's what I'm going to do. This is what I have for the mint. I've just basically literally shoved all the roots into a little vase and covered them with dirt, so I don't know if that's going to work or not. We will see. I'll let you know. But now I'm gonna get the peppers started in here. Okay, so I would love to hold you when I'm not messy anymore. But I'm going to dig a big hole. And I should have dressed you in something different so you could help, but wait just a minute.
Okay.
Alright. Can you hold this cup?
I'm just sitting.
I got time. It's clear to see. From up here.
The
world seems small. Now I'm just going to cover the top with the rest of the worm castings, and we will be on our way to a good plant, I hope. Okay, so here is the pepper plant. It's looking really nice. Elodie's shaking my arm, sorry. And here is the tomato plant. It's a little washed out. I wonder if I stand this way. Oh, there we go. Yeah, it's very bright out, but this is the tomato plant, that's the pepper plant, and then here is the mint that I was working on here. Don't know why it won't focus. I have to get something to figure that out, but yeah. So that's what I have there. There's Elodie. And hey guys, so I started this video a while back, but I basically killed my first garden in the frost, so those clips previously that you're gonna see, that did not end well. So it snowed in the middle of May and I lost my tomatoes, but the peppers did come up on their own. So today I just went out to a local nursery and I'm gonna show you what I got there and just kind of take you around plant planting and setting up our mobile garden space. So first I got this tomato plant, which I'm super excited about. It has like little tomatoes started already. My pepper plant is doing good. And then I also have these little red skin sweet peppers, which I'm excited about. And this one here, Elodie picked out herself. We got some little marigolds, which I'm gonna put in this pot, and she will be able to have her own little flowers. So I thought that would be really fun. I did have something planted in there. The squirrels have been eating all my seeds, so that's been a learning experience for sure. I did have popsicle sticks labeling things, but they ate the seeds, so that doesn't matter anymore. But let's just get into it and I'll show you how I'm gonna pot these and hopefully not kill them this time. So we are just gonna plant these marigolds into this little pot and hope that all of the dry soil does not blow away. Elodie, do you wanna come over and help with the flowers?
Yeah.
I'm gonna kinda transfer some of this soil into here to make room for the soil that is already a part of the plant. So we'll see how that goes. So these are the peppers that I already have planted. And then this one is where I'm gonna be putting the tomatoes here. So this is pretty rough looking. Please be careful with the peppers, Elodie. I just stuck these sticks in there to kind of stake the other tomatoes, but that didn't really work. So I'm just gonna try and like break this up and kind of move it around. You want to help me, Elodie? Kind of churn it up a little bit, get it going. All right. Now, this one's pretty deep. So, we need a bigger hole. Not that one, we leave this one alone. You can help me dig in this one. bit deeper. Oh, don't pick it up, don't pick it up. Thank you. Sorry.
Hi.
Thank you for wanting to help, though. Okay. Let's see. That's better. Okay. So I think we're ready. Please, Jesus, don't let me break it. I'm not really sure how you're meant to do this. There we go. Okay.
Bunch.
Bunch. This is a very precarious business.
Bunch. 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 We have bunching.
Cover it with dirt.
Wash it. Wash it.
Wash it.
Oh, yes.
Look at it. Okay, so I'm gonna put a couple of these stakes back in just to kind of help hold it up, maybe. I don't know. I'll be getting a tomato cage eventually. But until then, sticks will have to work. Okay. Cool, now we're gonna water it. And that'll be it.